kangaroo. Oh, gori gori, oh, bakke chori, chahe roz bula ya karo. Oh, gori gori, oh, bakke chori, kabhi meri gali aaya karo. Oh, gori gori, oh, bakke chori, chahe roz bula ya karo.
Yes.
County Sligo, a land of windswept mountains, surf-battered beaches, and poets. The famous W.B. Yeats is buried near here, and it's not for nothing that this was his favourite place in all of Ireland. I'm taking Kamal fishing for mackerel today. Now, mackerel is unbeatable when it's cooked fresh, so the challenge to Kamal to cook up a delicious dish this evening shouldn't prove too difficult.
To you.
Good morning, Alan. How are you?
Do you want to meet my mate Kamal here?
Hello, Kamal.
Oh, Rodney, how are you?
That's what's the fine. Fishing like?
Pretty good, not bad now at all. You got a lovely day for it.
Tell me two that you've got to be afraid of.
Blue sharks.
The jaws.
The water. Well, there's a big one. It's called the Great White, and it's only got a mouth about that size. And then there's one, well, so, I mean, you're not falling, don't worry.
No, we can't sure
swim.
Of that.
I can't swim.
Well, you said you were
1.5 meters.
That's it. Yeah, then you've had it.
You can have been swimming for 3 days now.
I'm afraid we'll be in much deeper water than that. So just don't fall out.
Okay.
Tell me, Alan, where did you get him? Where did you get him?
I'm from County Fermanagh.
He's from County Fermanagh.
Lord, you're going to fool me.
I'm a browned off Irish man.
Oh, very good.
You show me how to hook it and I'll show you how to cook it.
That's your reel?
Where is the reel?
That's the reel. That's
okay.
The
that there?
Yeah.
It's strong enough?
Yeah, it's strong enough. You can catch a whale in that before it bends.
Oh, yeah.
You got a brood of a thing, so you can catch the big one, I'll catch the wee one.
Okay. Okay. Let's go.
So all you do, come out, look. You turn that there, you hold it up like this. This hand goes in here. Like that.
There.
That's it. So what you do, Kamal, you hold it there,
right,
and you shove that in there, nice
ow!
And tight.
Okay.
And then what you do is this hand comes up and winds.
Would it help my stomach going in because I'm getting too fat?
I'll tell you, put it
that's
in your
the
belt. Stick it in your belt there. And then wind with this hand.
unwind like
wind,
that.
Wind. That's like it. Okay. Now, as you wind, that line comes in.
Yeah.
And when you want to drop it over the edge, you just lift that back and then it'll pay line out.
I see. And, when it's and pen, you don't need to do anything with that?
No. And no. When it's pen line out, then you move this hand back here and you put your thumb on there to control it.
When it is going down,
when
you
it's
mean?
Going down. Otherwise, it'll just overrun and you get a big mess.
But how is there a weight at the end of this?
Yeah, there is. What do you see now? What you do is you just take this little guy here. It's called a snap link.
Right.
And all you do is you tie a knot in it. Three turns.
Right.
And through. And pull it up.
Oh!
Randy!
What? Have you
just stopped your line?
He's some fisherman.
That's the most
he thinks he can catch fish.
What breaking strain's that line?
That is about 35 pounds.
Well, I must
strain.
Be friggin'
You're
Samson.
A strong lad, you're a strong boy.
Hasino ne bulaya, gale se bilagaya, bohat samuchaya, yehi na samucha. Hasino ne bulaya, gale se bilagaya, bohat samuchaya, yehi na samucha. Zamane bhar karna
kara. A few fish showing up around about 20 metres here.
Okay.
Just about 2 metres off the bottom.
Now this is the magic bit. Is there anything on the end, he says? So this is a quick change. Open her out, put that on. And you're away. And this is what you've got on the end. The business end. Look at that.
Aye, but you're supposed to get that many fish in one time?
Oh yeah. When you put
you
this
serious?
Down, every time you bring it up, you'll not catch one fish, but four. What happens is he swims around like mad, and then all these dance around and all the other fish come in and grab them as well. And they're mackerel we're fishing for. Have you ever seen a mackerel?
I have seen mackerel, yes.
You know what a mackerel is?
Yes, I have.
Right, let's give it a go, mate.
Okay.
I'll tell you
now,
what you
do I leave this on off?
Right, okay. Yeah. Well, when you drop it,
yes.
You can feel the weight. Now, oh, stop.
Okay. Aye, but how do
concerned.
You know how far is it going to go down?
Well, what you got to do, Kamal, is, I'll tell you what, wind it up again first.
Bring it back,
yeah.
Okay.
And what you can do is let it go all the way down to the bottom.
And that will be the seabed, like?
Yeah, you'll be right on the seabed. But as soon as you hit the seabed, lift it, because all those hooks will stick on the bottom. That's far enough now. Now, if you let her out.
Like that, there.
And then put your thumb on here immediately.
And when do I stop?
Well, I'll tell you. Now, she's running down under the weight. Now, just let it run out. Nice light pressure. Let it go fast. Let it go really fast. Now that's gone all the way down now. And the mackerel shoal and they swim at different depths.
Right.
So you got to just basically try at different depths. What you can do is go all the way to the bottom. And as soon as it stops, you stop it with your thumb.
There are a few fish showing up down on the bottom, lad. You want to go right down to the bottom.
This here?
Yeah, there are a few fish showing up on the bottom. But very close to the bottom. You want to keep it right down.
Yeah, yeah.
Put the lead right down. And
I have big...
I got it. Right, okay, wind.
No, maybe not.
Oh, okay, well, I'd say wind it in. Wind it in. As hard as you can go.
Yeehaw! And come on, fishy.
Hold it here. Hold
come
the rod
on,
up.
Come on, fishy,
up.
I got it.
Hold
I got
it on your
it.
Tummy.
I got it! Maybe. I have
oh, yes, hand. You got one.
Yes! Yes! Oh, I got more than one. Wow! Yeehaw! Holy God! Oh, last one! Get them back here! Oh my!
That's it, Al.
Oh, love it! But that's cruel, I think.
Do you want to try on hooking one?
No!
You sure?
Not the first one, anyway. Does it bite? Oh my God!
That's him? Look at
that. And what do you do with this now? Wow!
Hold him.
Oh, wow! Oh wow!
He's
my
slippy,
God!
He? Aren't they beautiful little fish?
Wow! Did you catch any? Oh, you got a different colour.
No, they're all the same. Should we catch some more?
You are dead right.
Let's do it.
I'm on now.
Kamal, that's just the start. Those are mackerel, and we're going to use those for bait. So what we do is we cut them up, and then we use the smaller fish to catch.
To get a bigger fish.
You betcha.
Wow! Well, I'm into fishing now. I am into fishing.
Another convert.
Wow, this is fantastic.
Hua chuka bhi razi, ko mila nahi kazi, jahan pe lagi baazi.
I think, Kamal, you'll be cooking for more than two or three here.
You're right.
You have enough mackerel to feed a complete family.
this time.
Can I invite my family?
You are welcome.
Thank you very much.
Our God is Lord Krishna.
Lord Krishna, right.
No, it's all right. God's still the same.
No, honest, it's the truth. It's the truth, what I'm telling
you. I have got it! Yes, baby, big one! Mighty, 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 mighty! Big one is... Well, it's a bigger one. Yes, it is a big one. Oh, jeepers. Look at that! Look at that!
Oh, yes, I'm in. I got one.
You're in.
Ah! Oh, I have got...
Rather, your reels.
Yes! I've got too many of them. It's very... Oh, I lost it.
I
lost
here, guys.
I lost it. Ah. I think I lost it.
Rodney, how big does the fish have to be before this rod will bend?
Oh, it has...
I had a very big one there.
7 pounds, 8 pounds.
Look, it's a...
Oh, wow!
It's a pouting.
I have a pouting.
Ha-ha!
I have one too! Yes! Look at that!
Yours is bigger than
mine! Look at that! Wow!
Look at that, Kamal. 2 minutes and two species.
I had
two different kinds of fish.
That's a good pouting.
I had two or three of them.
Oh my God!
That's a very good one.
Is it?
The pouting is a member of the cod family. We have this under his chin, you see?
Yes.
He's got the barbel under his chin.
And what does that mean?
Member of the cod family.
Oh, it is the cod family.
The cod, the ling, and the pouting have that.
So am I getting better at this or what? Oh.
Almost round in section. You see how much meat's on that?
Yes.
They're very powerful fish. You see also the camouflage, isn't that absolutely beautiful?
Absolutely.
And then from underneath he's just white silver.
That's right.
And if you want to take meat off him, simple, one cut straight down just behind the fin, turn the knife flat, follow all the way along the spine, keep it pressed down, and that's it.
That's your fillet.
That's your fillet. Lovely slab of meat. Isn't that superb?
It's lovely. Beautiful colour. A nice fresh fish.
We'll have them jumping in the pan, Kamal.
Huh?
They'll be jumping in the pan.
I'm telling you, they will be.
No, I missed it. Bang on.
I missed it.
No, it's bang on.
Watch it eat it.
La 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 la.
Don't smell it too hot, it's chili powder. That is very hot, man.
Good man. That's super. I didn't know you had your own brand.
It's a Merlot, I think.
It's a Merlot?
Merlot.
So it's not a cheap blend,
not at all. We don't believe in that.
So what are you going to do with this fish?
What we are going to do first is we are going to marinate it. Yeah. Now, you have to learn how to cook. Yeah?
You telling me
and
I don't
I'm
know
gonna
how
teach
to
you
cook?
How to cook. Next!
Who is next?
That's latex.
Is this so you don't get the smell all over your hands?
No. It's just whenever we are going to use the marinade, you see, you'll have a dye on your hands otherwise. The fish is fine. We took the bones out earlier on.
Took the bones out earlier on.
Yes.
Kamal,
but
I'll have you know.
we are actually going to make it as a tandoori. Tandoori, what is this fish called? Mackerel, isn't it?
Mackerel.
Mackerel.
Do you have mackerel in India?
No, we have jackfish in India. What we're going to do is, we just put some yogurt, yeah?
Is this mackerel masala?
No. This is very special dish I'm going to make. Put some more mackerel in that, you know? It's garlic. No. Have you done this before?
Nah. I've still got all my fingers. No, I've never done that before.
Okay. Well, you will now. I'll show you how to do it.
That knife looks very sharp.
It is.
I see you just rub it up and down your knuckle.
Yeah.
So you never actually come into contact with your finger. Anybody got finger stew in your restaurant?
Yeah, loads of times.
Do you mind if I have a go with that?
Well, that's the whole idea. Now we're going to put some garlic there. Try one of those cloves there.
So
now whenever you're going this, always make sure you have your, like that.
Okay.
Even go gently.
Yeah, okay.
Fine. You know, okay. No need to do it in a rush, like. Don't do it fast. Let's go.
Keep the tongue in.
Oh, we have fish finger curry. Fish finger curry.
I'll tell you something, it is a lot harder than it looks.
No, fish finger curry. Oh, ginger and garlic is the base ingredients of Indian cooking.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Ginger?
Without ginger and garlic, you can't get nothing right.
Right. Super stuff, Kamal. Super stuff. That looks really slick.
Well, practice.
That'll take me about 10 minutes.
I've cut myself about 1,000 times before.
Brilliant.
I was able to do this.
Absolutely brilliant.
Now, that's what we're going to do.
A lot of ginger going in there.
Yeah.
That's what it's all about.
A bit of fresh coriander again.
And the fresh coriander is a bit more.
And then, of course, use the good old tandoori paste because we are going to make a tandoori mackerel. So you need tandoori paste.
So we aren't doing mackerel masala then?
No.
I've always looked forward to mackerel masala.
Mackerel masala.
Now, so what you're saying is you can actually take just about any meat or fish and you can basically add your Indian spices and there you
anything,
go, you've got an Indian
anything
dish.
Anything at all. That's a bit of salt. Smell that.
Ooh.
That's a combination of about 7-8 different spices and it's called garam masala.
Oh, garam masala.
Garam masala. Garam means hot.
Well, is it true, Kamal, that they put all these spices in the meats originally to preserve the meats?
Well, what they used to say about curries was whenever they were going off, or any meats going off, they used to put spices and add all these things.
I can't say it looks too appetizing right at this point in time, Kamal.
Well, it won't because once it is cooked, it has to marinate now for a while. And it has to stay like this. Even the wasps love it. We are going to make
mackerel steaks.
Steaks is right. Yeah.
Tremendous. So what are you going to do with these?
What I'm going to do is I'm going to fry it first. We're just going to put the oil in the pan. And then
take them out.
Throw them in there.
Kamal, they'll stick to the bottom very quickly, won't they?
I don't think so.
May
got...
I?
Oh, yeah. You can
try. Oh, look at that. Look at that. They're sticking already.
Oh.
I need something. Right, Kamal, these are starting to break up now. Will I lift them off?
Are they? No, leave them there for a wee minute. What we're going to do is throw some garlic. Let some garlic cook. Oops.
That's a heavy pan.
That's a very heavy pan, yeah.
We're just going to put this in this.
Shall I just shovel it in? There we are. So that's mackerel sticks that have just been lightly seared in garlic and oil.
Yeah. Well, normally I would use olive oil, but I went to the shop up there to find out if they had an olive oil, but they didn't.
So. I tell you what, it doesn't have smell good, I'm telling you.
And let's cook some onions.
Onion!
Have you good this onion?
What's this stuff now?
That's cumin seeds. I'm going to put some cumin seeds.
Into the butter?
Well, we just have to cook the cumin seeds. As you know, I mean, it's not proper cooking. It's a barbecue, so the heat is not even. So we had to cook the cumin first before we went into the onions, but...
So you want to keep this separate on the heat?
Well, I just want to cook that first, you see.
How do you cook cumin seeds?
Yeah, they will go darker in color.
Ah, right.
And you will smell the flavor.
Right.
You can already smell it. We are going to add the rest of the spices. For example, turmeric.
Right.
And there is a garam masala you put in. You put salt and chili to your taste. And then we are going to put some water into it to make it into a curry.
Oh yes. So you've got a wet sort of sauce.
Yes.
So you're making this into a sauce and then you put the fish in.
Exactly.
Right. The chef.
Whenever the chef sits and have a glass of wine, the assistant should be cooking.
Well, if you tell me what to do, I'll do it.
Just, you see, this is the thing about Indian cooking, patience. If you have the patience, that is it.
So do you just want me to stir this around
just
a bit?
Just keep it going, and whenever it is golden brown, I'm going to show you what spice is going to it.
Okay.
And great. We are going to make it a wee bit nice and hot. You know?
So right at this point in time, we've got onions.
Onions and cumin.
Garlic.
No garlic in there.
Onions.
Because we put garlic with the fish.
Oh, that's right. We have the garlic in the fish.
If we put too much garlic or too much ginger, then you will taste ginger, but no fish.
Right.
We're going to add turmeric, first of all, because turmeric has to cook. Turmeric has to cook.
Right.
So when you cook these, a lot.
Does it change the flavor when you cook them?
I never measure. So there you go. That's plenty.
So this is turmeric.
This is turmeric, yeah. Turmeric, actually, is the right word.
Or as the Irish say, turmeric. It's
now,
a flower.
Now, chili. How much do you want? Oof. Little bit.
Do you eat hot food
all the time? Yes.
So it's going to sort of burn the mouth of you?
It's going to burn, yes. Uh-huh. Of course. You need that tiny bit of heat. Now, these are plum tomatoes. So what we're going to do is, we're just going to smash them. See the plum tomatoes?
Oh, yuck. But you just break it up into pulp.
Of course. You need a base, you see. Isn't that nice looking?
Yeah, it's really coming together now.
Isn't it?
That's really impressive. It's actually not as difficult, you know. I mean, I'm not a chef at all, but...
You never will be.
People say to you, well, you know, chefing's really difficult, but... Yeah. It's a piece of cake, it's just knowing what to put in next, really, isn't it? What do you call that stuff? Coconut?
It's coconut cream.
Coconut cream, right. And if you melt it in that water, it's coconut milk.
That's right. We are going to add a few things to it, give it final touches, for example. Put a bit of cashew nuts. Isn't that lovely? Love spring onion. Normally, you wouldn't put it in the recipe, but I love spring onion. So what I'm going to do is just add that. Look at this now. We're going to just pour this mackerel in there.
Juice and all,
because that's the flavor.
Now, I suppose, obviously, you don't want this
fish
broken
up. Now, you have to be very careful.
Gentle touch, eh?
Very, very gently. Because we don't want that fish to stay raw either.
But that fish is 3/4 cooked now, isn't it?
That's right. It is nearly finished. The only thing we have to do is squeeze a bit of lemon juice on it. Why not?
That's what it's all about.
A bit of fresh coriander again. But what we're going to do is just close this and let it cook.
for about 5 minutes.
And then what we are going to do is
eat these pita bread there and eat it.
Oh, gory, gory. Oh, bakke chori. Kabhi meri gali aaya karo. Oh, gory, gory. Oh, bakke chori. Chahe roz bulaya karo. Oh, gory, gory. Oh, bakke chori. Kabhi meri gali aaya karo. Oh, gory, gory. Oh, bakke chori. Chahe roz bulaya karo. मुलाकात अच्छी नहीं, प्यार में ऐसी बात अच्छी नहीं, थोड़ा थोड़ा मिला थोड़ी सी जुदाई, सता चांदनी अच्छी नहीं, ओ छोड़ो छोड़ो दिया ना तोड़ो, किसी और को चलाया करो, ओ गोरी गोरी, ओ बाकी चोरी, चाहे रोज बुलाया करो.
What do you think?
Kamal, that was a fabulous day.
Yeah?
And I never ever killed a mackerel.
Yeah?
Cracking.
Neither have I. Neither have I.
I just look forward to the trout and the salmon.
It has to be done. We'll do it. We'll do it.
Right.